133. Behold how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. It is like the precious ointment upon the head that ran down upon the beard, even Aaron's beard, that went down to the skirts of his garments, and the dew of Hermon as the dew that descended upon the mountains of Zion. For there the Lord commanded the blessing, even life for evermore. Life for evermore. In verse 2, it is like the precious ointment upon the head. What is like the precious ointment? It is like the precious ointment. What is brethren to dwell together in unity? Brethren dwelling together in unity. Brethren dwelling together in unity. That is like the precious ointment upon the head that ran down upon the beard, even Aaron's beard, that went down to the skirts of his garment. So this ointment, this holy oil, this anointing oil, this ointment is like brethren dwelling together in unity. Brethren living together, dwelling together in unity is like this ointment. Or this ointment is like brethren living together in unity. Last week we were able to study about this ointment. What are the ingredients in that ointment? And how that ointment is compounded? And how precious that ointment is. In Exodus chapter 30, from verse 22 to 33, we're able to see the ingredients in that ointment, and that how that ointment was compounded by the art of an apothecarist. So there are principal spices: myrrh, sweet cinnamon, sweet calamus, and cassia. The sweet or the pure myrrh has got 5 properties: fragrance, medicinal. The first 2 properties are common for all these 4 spices. The special property, this myrrh, though it was bitter, it is used for purification. It is used for purification. And number 4, it's used for preservation. Number 3, it was used as a sedation. Number 5, it's used as a sedation. So if we have got a nature, if we can have a contributory nature that will help others purifications, that will help others preservation, and that will help as a sedation, a pain reliever, a stress buster for others, dwelling together in unity, it is very simple. So we must have the nature of myrrh that's also pure myrrh. A myrrh that's not collected because of incision. Pure myrrh, it speaks about myrrh that oozes out spontaneously. Then the second one we studied, sweet cinnamon. Cinnamon is a tree that will grow very tall, and it's very strong, and it belongs to the family of laurel. From that word only we get a laurel family. The property of cinnamon, basically, it is used to enforce enthusiasm with courage, lion-heartedness with bravery, high-spirited with excitement. If we have that nature, encouraging others, high-spirited, not zombies, with a good spirit, bubbling, enthusiasm, some people are high-spirited. They got a lot of cinnamon in them. I know one brother, for many things I depend on him. If I tell him, hey, how was the day? Oh, I went here, I went there, went around. Yes, Pastor, tell me what? No, can you come? Where to come? I'll come now. But are you tired? No, no. The other day I met a girl. She must be around 11 or 12. She was saying, 11 or 12. Rumba tired. Had a shock. Maybe to some extent only now I know what tired means. In my 30s, in my 40s, I don't know what is meant by tired. I don't know what is meant by tired. I never had an idea what is tiredness would be. Tired. Be always like bubbling. You would be able to bring unity in the family, jumping, infusing encouragement to others, making others type of be happy. So this cinnamon, other than fragrant and medicinal, it's high and lofty, hard and strong, spicy. Spicy, it's a type of an encouraging. It's not a spicy taste, it's a spicy smell. It's a spicy smell. Then we saw sweet calamus. Sweet calamus. Sweet calamus is the lemongrass or gingergrass. This lemongrass, the meaning of that Hebrew word is to create, to erect, as we erect a building. It will erect enthusiasm. And lemongrass is the first one that will emit its fragrance even at the touch of the breeze. At the touch of the breeze, it will emit its fragrance and it will not lose its fragrance. It limits its fragrance, it will not lose its fragrance. Just yielding to the Holy Spirit immediately, without much struggle, without much breaking your head. Is it the will of God or it's not the will of God? Well, in my life, the other day I was sharing my testimony. One part I said, it was very simple for me. I mean, it's a nature. We all must desire this nature. It's very simple for me to yield to the leading of the Holy Ghost. Yield to the leading of the Holy Ghost. When the Lord just spoke to me through one servant of God, when I was thinking about marriage, marrying sister, I didn't know anything about her. I didn't know how she would become a compliment to my life. I never seen her. We're in the same Sunday school, we're in the same VBS. When I didn't know her, I never talked to her one word. God is a witness. I'm standing in the presence of God and I'm saying, when this proposal came to through pastor, he said, I give you 3 days. This is what I say, this calamus. I give you 3 days. You should say yes or no. I don't know how immediately to say yes or no. I never seen. I've not even seen a photograph. I didn't know anything. Only one thing, I want the leading of the Holy Ghost. I said yes. 3 days. It's a type of a spiritual situation where I have to take a decision. Whether I take a right decision or a wrong decision depends upon that one day. Or 3 days, okay. From Prasavakam, I have to go to Secretariat Colony. I started walking down. My dear brother, my dear sister, Kallis, there's a pastor and his wife. His wife had the grace of prophesying, of speaking their hidden things. Just I went to them. There, I was helping them in their ministry. So we three started praying. They didn't know anything about what's in my mind. We three started praying. Just an example for calamus. We three started praying. Then a word came to them. This is of the Lord. Is it Kartharalvan, the Bayapada? As the angel was speaking to Mary, just these words came. When she finished the prayer, she asked me, "Enna thambi, enna yosra?" I was just 24 years old. "Enna thambi, enna yosra vandinga? Enna thambi, enna yosra vandinga?" I said, "What the Lord has revealed this, the Lord will reveal that to you." I went home. I didn't pray for it. I didn't think about it. Next morning, that's the second day, Pastor Sundaram saw me. He said, "Na jom mandri ra." Panala pastor. "Hey!" No, Rabbi knows. This is how he talks. "Hey! Jom manna sonna liya." Jom manla pastor. "Why? God has spoken to me. Why should I pray? God has spoken to me. Why should I pray?" Innocent. This is what God said. "This is of the Lord. Fear not, this is of the Lord. Go ahead, pastor." In that period, I know another evangelist. He said, "Before we should accept, we should see A to Z." I said, "What is A to Z?" "Age, beauty, caste, dowry, education, fairness, goodness. A to Z," he said. My dear brother, my dear sister, mine was not A to Z. It was beyond that, what God wants me. And till this day we are happy. And we know that we are complimenting one another. We are making one another complete. That's what the word complimenting means. Making other complete. My dear brother, my dear sister, why I say that sweet fragrance yielding to the Holy Spirit. Otherwise your life would become miserable. The life would become miserable. February 26th or 27th, the Lord told me. The Lord told me that I should help Pastor Sundaram. After one day I told Prabhu. She also shared with me about her vision. When next day we went and talked to Pastor Sundaram. With all humility I tell you, there were negative comments about Pastor Sundaram to me. But when the Lord told me, "Help Pastor Sundaram," immediately, my dear brother, my dear sister, in those days, I was a known evangelist. So Lord wants me to come for the full-time ministry. So I can just be a world, I become an evangelist. I can go to different places, preach. I can have my own prayers. The Lord told me, "Help Sundara." I just resigned my job, went. I didn't consult with my father. You know, after I tendered my resignation, when my family members came to my brother, he loves me very much. He came with one of his family friends, with a towel on his shoulders. He started sobbing bitterly. He asked me a question. "By selling my wife's bangle, I paid your examination fees. You got 3 degrees. Without consulting us, how can you resign? I only paid your examination fees. How much parents suffered to give you this education? How could you resign the job without telling us?" I showed love to him. I showed love to him. I thought, within 3 days, 4 days, I gave my resignation. Immediately I obeyed the Lord. This is a calamity. I don't know why I'm speaking to you again this. Many years after that, I had been to Marthandam to be a preacher in the full gospel Pentecostal church, general convention. In one of the morning sessions, Pastor Thomas Aya, one of the saints I revere, he was taking up the Bible study. He was also a teacher. He was taking up the Bible study. So I just went, sat at the back. I wanted to listen to that saint. That saint said, in the classroom, when he was taking the attendance, the Lord asked him a question. Indha velaikka na avan alaichen. He was taking attendance in the classroom. Indha velaikka na avan alaichen. He closed down his pen, closed down the attendance register. Without telling anybody, he walked out of the school. Maybe ethically I don't agree with that. But that day, I broke down. Lord, for me it took 4 days. There is a saint who immediately obeyed. Lord, I took 4 days to give my resignation after you spoke to me. I went and talked to Pastor Sundaram. Probably I didn't talk to my daddy or mommy. I talked to Pastor Sundaram. We both went. But there is a saint before me. As soon as there is an inner voice, he obeyed. That is the lemon cross. At the touch of the Holy Spirit. Sometimes the decisions would be very difficult. The decisions may be very difficult. My dear brother, my dear sister, when a time came that I have to come out of the church where I was, I loved them, they loved me. When there was a situation, I had a struggle. Not scared to sleep on the platform, but I didn't know where I could keep my books. My dear brother, my dear sister, not knowing what will happen to me, I went, I talked to my pastor. My pastor laid his hands on me and said, do as the Lord leads. My dear brother, my dear sister, I don't know what I'll be doing. I don't know how the Lord would lead. Just yielded to the Lord. The Lord was leading wonderfully. So whatever the Spirit of the Lord speaks to you, yield to the leading of the Spirit. Your marriage, your ministry. There's a small quarrel between somebody. The Lord says, stop. Immediately stop it. Find the joy in yielding. This is the calamus. Then dwelling together in unity is very simple. I dwell together in unity till the end with my pastor. For his 75th birthday, hundreds of saints came. He insisted that I should speak. I had a wonderful, that's one of the cherishest moment in my life. But I was not bragging about it. I didn't even tell the church that I was going to speak. I didn't want to come anybody there. I didn't want to tell the church I'm going to speak in this meeting. It's an opportunity God gives. When I went to conduct the marriage of a celebrant servant of God, after that they asked, oh, you didn't tell us. Why should I tell them? He called me to solemnize the marriage. I went and solemnized. He asked me to speak in his birthday. I went and spoke. I was not making a propaganda about that. It's a very simple thing. My dear brother, my dear sister, just yield. If you have got this calamus in you, dwelling together in unity is very simple. Yield to the Holy Spirit. It's easy. And the fourth one, Kazia. It is dark, harder, thicker, corrosive. And this nature we saw fragrance medicine and humility and surrender. Very tough. Humility and surrender at the same time very tough. And for the Jews is a sign of prayer. And the fourth one, the fifth one, oil olive. This oil olive is for the greasy. There will be frictions between sisters, brothers, husband and wife, mamiyar, marumaga. Then you must have the nature to grease it. You should not add the friction. You must be able to grease it. That's why the oil is necessary. It gives a shining, glossy finish. Oil is for richness. Again, it's preserving odors, and especially olive oil preserves that odor, the nature of others, the love, that peace. You must be able to preserve that. And the fifth one, olive always speaks for hope, peace, victory, etc. This is the best preservative of odors. So we must have all these five ingredients: cinnamon, calamus, cassia, myrrh, and oil. Compound it, take it in the prescribed quantity, and compound it with an art of apothecary, perfumer. That is the ointment. So that is the nature that will make brethren live together in unity. That nature will make brethren live together in unity. But I love to move on. Now it says in verse 2, it is, brethren joining together in unity, is like the precious ointment. So we heard about that ointment. Now he says, the ointment, not in the flask, not in the bottle, not in the heart, the ointment that is poured upon the head, that ran down upon the beard, even Aaron's beard, that went down to the skirts of his garments. This nature is very essential, but please listen, that ointment with myrrh, calamus, cinnamon, cassia, olive oil, that ointment is not like brethren dwelling together in unity. What is then? Not the ointment. The ointment that is poured upon the head of Aaron. So it is not that ointment. We had to study about the nature of that ointment, but not that ointment. That ointment, when it is poured upon the head of Aaron, when it runs down on his beard, when it goes down on his skirts of his garment, that is likened for brethren dwelling together in unity. Brethren dwelling together in unity. So 3 points. Kindly make a note. I love that you all bring your notepad and taking down notes. And I want you to see your own Bible. Please participate. Number one, you can make a note. How this can become brethren dwelling together in unity, not just the ointment is essential, but not the ointment in the flask, not the ointment in the horn, not the ointment in the bottle. Number one, ointment that is poured out. That woman, she broke the alabaster box, a bottle, and she poured the ointment upon Jesus' head. The whole room was filled with that scent. As long as you are keeping that within you, as long as you are keeping all this good nature, the nature of cinnamon, the nature of calamus, the nature of cassia, the nature of oil olive, all these things you keep within and put it cocked, fully cocked, as they keep the zin in the cock. You cocked it. Nobody is going to be benefited. It is not brethren dwelling together in unity. Brethren dwelling together in unity is pouring out. That alabaster box should be broken. That shell should be broken. Some people will pour out something that only to spread stink, bad odor, very irritatingly pungent, but pour forth perfume. Pour for perfume, your words, your look, your actions, your smile, that should cheer others. Just give a small example how it is poured forth. There is a dark situation. The husband is sitting as if the ship is sinking. The wife is more worried. He is sitting on the chair. What to do next? What to do next? The wife comes with a hot, fragrant cup of coffee. That coffin smell. Nice coffee. There is a smile at her face. Pain inside. Pain inside. But she is a mother. She preserves his faith. Don't worry. Adhan kavalapadadhinga. Daddy, kavalapadadhinga, Daddy. She speaks out. He is broken. She comes and says, "Enna eppadi kallu pillaiyar maari ukkandirukkeenga? Enna panna poringa?" The broken man will be shattered. Kavalapadadhinga. Coffee saavudunga. He looks at her. There is a loving smile. She puts her hand on the back, pulls him closer. Kandipa kathar saivar. She is the mother. Preservative, sedative. Namma rendu per onna fasting in the chabipo. We'll fast and pray. Cinnamon, lofty. The problem, the earthly problem. She has got the knack to turn the problem to a spiritual area. We'll pray. We'll pray. Enna javicham? Illa, we'll continue to pray. See, cinnamon is coming. Be of good cheer. Come on, let's go. Just come on, we'll go for a ride. We'll go and meet pastor and come. Enge varashtam? Vaanga pa poyittu varalam. Cinnamon, infusing courage. Papa itala pastor poi paathu avaru enna solvaru ella sariya pogum paaru solvaru la sariya perukla poidum vaanga polam. Cinnamon is there. Immediate obedience, calmness is there. Prayer life, cashier is there. Adding oil to the friction, oil is there. Living together in unity, it's very simple. Only when she puts that in action, when she pours forth, what is that we pour forth? So number one, it should be poured out. All this nature you are keeping within you. Already I got problem. Introvert. Already I am bitter. Already I am darker. Already I am coarse. Already I am insist. I am thinking about it within myself. I am not poured out. If at all I poured out venom. I poured out bitterness. I poured out sorrowness. I just make others feel sorry. I remember Anandjeevananda used to say that kavala worry is a contagious disease. Worry is a contagious disease. There's a problem in the office. So this man come with a swollen face. She asks, "Yenanga? Huh? Why mode? Yenanga? Why modeengrenla?" She immediately, "Amma yenla solla mating, unga amma ta solluvinga, avata solluvinga, ivata solluvinga." She transfer that problem into hell. Instead of transferring the problem to higher area, she transfer the problem to a bottom area. அவன் ஏன்லாம் சொல்லுவீங்களா? அவங்க அம்மா நான் போய் சொல்லுவீங்க, என் மேல உங்களுக்கு அன்பு இல்ல. ஹி இஸ் ஆல்ரெடி ப்ரோக்கன் அண்ட் ஷீ இஸ் ரப்பிங் சால்ட் இன் தட். என்னங்க ப்ராப்ளம்? ஷீ இஸ் நேகிங். இஃப் ஐ டோன்ட் சே ஷீ வாண்ட் டு கீப் குவைட், இமீடியட்லி ஷீ சேட், ஆபீஸ்ல ப்ராப்ளம். ஆபீஸ்ல என்ன ப்ராப்ளம்? சொன்னா நீ கிழிச்சிருவியா? ஹவு கேன் தே லிவ் டுகெதர் இன் யூனிட்டி? நவ் த ப்ராப்ளம் கம்ஸ் ஆன் ஹர். The boy was playing outside. He comes running with all bubbling joy. Hey, daddy!
Hey, go on, go.
What, man?
Don't go to daddy.
Daddy is angry.
Don't talk to him.
He'll beat you. When he's in bad mood, he's devil. So that mother will be telling the child, your father is devil. What a good lesson.
கோபம் வந்துச்சுன்னா கிட்ட கோபம் அச்சுகார் போகாத கிட்ட.
Now the worry this man brought from the office, it caught the wife, now that boy. The girl was coming from the school, தங்கச்சி. அம்மா
அம்மா அழுதுகிட்டு இருக்கா, கம்மனு பயிரும் இல்ல
இல்ல எல்லாத்தையும் ஒன்னு
சாத்திரும். அம்மா கண்டேஜியஸ்.
Now everybody has become sad. There is no cinnamon inside. There is no cinnamon inside. Suppose the husband says to the wife, don't worry about the office problem. He changes it to a higher area. If this is not the place, the Lord will open up another way for us. Be of good courage. When there was a situation came, I told my wife, don't worry. Don't worry. I love to drive auto. I can go for auto. I'll just be auto water parent. My wife didn't say, no, do you, நான் ஒரு ஆட்டோக்காரியா கல்யாணம் கட்டினேன், நான் பெரிய கல்வி பள்ளிக்கூடத்தில் வாத்தியாரெல்லாம் கல்யாணம் கட்டினேன், ஊழியெல்லாம் செய்வேன் கட்டில் ஆட்டோவா ஓட்ட போறேன், ஆட்டோக்காரன் மன்னிவியாக நான் இருக்கணும். She was not making efforts. This is the grace I got because I yielded to the Holy Spirit. She said, okay. Whether you be in the ministry or whether you be a teacher or you're not a driver, as long as the Lord leads, it's good. Said, we'll do. So we are able to see something next. But the Lord has got his own plans. So you must be able to pour out, speak the words of courage, speak the words of love, speak the words of encouragement. Number two, it is not pouring out the ointment in the room. There is a small piggy there. I pour out this ointment on the pig. What will that pig do? After receiving all this ointment, the pig will go and again it will wallow in the chakada, mud, gutter. So the Lord is very careful, not only pouring out the ointment, pour out the ointment on Aaron's head. This is like the ointment that is poured out on Aaron's head. Ointment poured out on Aaron's head. What do you mean by that ointment poured out Aaron? Not on anybody else's head, not on Moses' head, not on somebody else's head. There's an ointment poured out on David's head. There's an ointment poured out on Saul's head. But the Lord says, brethren living together in unity, it is like the ointment poured on Aaron's head. Very quickly, I give you 4 points about Aaron. Very quickly, let me give you 4 points about Aaron. Aaron is called by God, chosen by God, separated from other Israelites, and joined with Moses, taken to be together with Moses. So it's not throwing pearls before pigs, swines. It is not wasting that ointment on somebody else. Here there is a man who is called by God, chosen by God, separated from all the other Israelites, and taken to be with Moses before this ointment is poured forth. Let your family, your husband, wife, children, called with a holy calling, a high calling, heavenly calling. There are three callings. You can make a note of all these things. Holy calling, high calling, heavenly calling. We are called. We are not only called, a family, a chosen family for God's purpose. Then only this principle will apply. Our life is chosen for God's purpose. So call chosen is not enough. Separated from others, even separated from other Christians, and taken to Moses, joined with Moses. அவன் இஸ்ரவேல் புத்திரிலிருந்து பிரித்து உன்னோடு கூட சேர்த்துக்கும். Joined with Jesus Christ. Not what other Christians do. Not what other Christians, what the Bible says. What the Bible says. How the Bible is interpreted in the truth. The word of God is Jesus. The word of God is Jesus. So upon him, this ointment should be poured forth. So brethren, living together in unity is not a very simple thing. Abraham and Lot could not live together in unity. Sons of Jacob could not live together in unity. They could not live together in unity. So living together in unity, we must have the ingredients of that ointment, and it should be to a prescribed measurement and should be prepared as God has dictated. Again, that should not be just in a bottle or a flask or in a horn. It should be poured out. Poured out on Aaron's head. A man who is called, chosen, separated, and joined with Jesus. When we have this nature, I am for Jesus. I am for Jesus, my wife is for Jesus. We want to do the will of God. We surrender to the will of God. When we are called, chosen, separated, set apart, and joined with the word of God, this ointment poured forth, that will be like brethren dwelling together in unity. It's not pouring that ointment on the pig. It will be smelling good for some time, but it cannot retain it for a long time. As long as the anointing is upon your head, as long as this ointment is upon your head, this anointing must be upon our head. A pig cannot retain that anointing. He'll again go to the mud to wallow. And number three, I come to the major part of today's message. Number three, when it is poured upon Aaron, there was a prescription upon his head, upon his beard, and the skirts of his garment. What is literally meant by the skirts of his garment? The Hebrews suggest to the mouth of the garment. To the mouth of the garment. And some translation I say to the collar. To the collar of his robe. Earlier I thought the skirts of the garment, it is up to the end. That's also that mouth. That mouth, I don't know whether the opening in the neck or the opening at the bottom. His garment. To the mouth of the garment. And my simple imagination, though they said it's only collar, my simple imagination when we say skirts, even by the word skirts, or even that word by the mouth of that garment, he cannot put it through that small hole for the neck. I think the mouth of the garment must be the skirt at the bottom. The skirt at the bottom. That can be used for both. The mouth of the garment. I just take it the full robe. It doesn't just stop with the collar. It just drips down. He poured it abundantly. Maybe even it touches the end of the garment. But it's very careful, it doesn't spill on the ground. It doesn't spill on the ground. So this anointing, or this perfume, this compound of myrrh, cinnamon, calamus, cassia, with olive, oil olive, this anointing or this ointment poured on the head, runs down on the face and went on his garment. So I call this head, face and robe. Head, face and robe. What do these three things mean? The Bible says 1 Thessalonians 4:13, we all know very well. Our spirit, soul and body must be holy. Our spirit, soul and body must be holy. This anointing must touch our spirit. I'm not talking about the Holy Spirit. Our spirit, we have got a spirit. There are so many unclean things in our spirit. This anointing poured on the head, spiritually or symbolically mean, this anointing must touch our spirit. My dear brother, my dear sister, if you turn with me, to 2 Corinthians 7, 1, having therefore this promise, dearly beloved, let us cleanse ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh and spirit. All filthiness of the spirit. God willing, we'll take a separate study on the filthiness of the spirit, flesh and body. To be specific, the filthiness of the spirit. This anointing must touch the filthiness of the spirit. What are the filthiness in the spirit? Lust in the spirit, slumber in the spirit, irritation in the spirit, adultery in the spirit, not just in the flesh. Adultery in the flesh, poyyinavi, vibacharathinavi, kalanginavi. I'm just putting it in Tamil so that everybody could understand easy. Kalanginavi, irichalinavi, irritation, provoked spirit, broken spirit. Our spirit, angry, eddukaduthalum kovam, disturbed in the spirit. We may not have a reason, enmity in the spirit, mukhandaram illamal pagaitharu. They hated somebody without cause, that's a problem in the spirit. They hated somebody without cause. Kananitrayinavi. Anytime, every time, want to sleep. It's a problem with the spirit. Certain problems may look like it's a problem in the body, but that may be a problem in the spirit. Bayatinavi, fear of spirit. They will fear, scared to get into a lift, scared to stand on a high place and to look down, stand to be alone in a room, scared of darkness, a spirit problem. A spirit problem. So for you to dwell together in unity with others, this oil, this nature of the Holy Spirit, touch our spirit. Touch our spirit. Our spirit must become a simple spirit. Avil ellime ullavargal bakiyavan. Poor in the spirit. Kalangam illada. The spirit is not disturbed. Pure spirit. Innocent spirit. Frank spirit. Spirit with no deception, no pretension. Unfeigned spirit. Mayamilladavara. Clean water. Virgin water. Our spirit must be clean. I'm not talking about the Holy Spirit. The real born again experience. When the Holy Spirit touches our spirit. So it's poured upon his head. This anointing must touch our spirit. That should become our nature. And again we read in chapter 7 verse 1, having Therefore, these promises, dearly beloved, let us cleanse ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh. Here the flesh, mamsam, doesn't speak about our body. Here the flesh speaks about our carnal man. A mamsa sindai, carnally minded. Our thought process, our decision making process. There are a lot of filthiness. The world, the flesh, the devil will always work against the will of God. Want to resign your job? The world will say, oh, don't resign. Don't believe in Sundaram. And I was resigning my job. Somebody came and told me, I say openly. So far I never said this. But to make point clear, somebody came and told me. You may be wrong, but he told me, a person I respected very much, came and told me, Sundaramna Thandaram. Sundaratirve Matikad. Sundaramna Thandaram. God led me. God led me. Our mindset. If you are spiritually minded, peace. Peace. There are very few occasions, those who are with me, they know. There are very few occasions my mindedness will be disturbed. I may get annoyed. I may shout at the people, those are helping me. It's not because I hate them, I love them. The boys here, those who help me the most, they get the most shouting. The willing horse is killed. No soldier is going to take a horse that's not cooperative. Which horse will go to the battlefield? Only the horse that is cooperative. Only the horse that can go well. But that has the task. He'll beat that horse. He'll pull its reins. He'll press the spur. He loves that horse. He'll give his life for that horse. It is a cherished treasure. But he'll beat that horse. Can you see that? He'll beat that horse. He'll pull the rein of that horse. That horse is taken to task. But that's the horse he can depend for battle. My dear brother, my dear sister. So we may be harsh at people when they are willing to help me. Those who are willing to help me, I'll be harsh at them. But I love them. But I never allow my peace to be disturbed, even if it is disturbed, just momentary. Just momentary. My dear brother, my dear sister, carnally minded is death. Your thought process. If you want brethren to dwell together in unity, there are wrinkles. There are areas we don't understand one to another. My dear brother, my dear sister, I don't profess we eat just only Thenitta Paniyaram every day. I love spices. There will be chili, there will be pepper, there will be pahaka. All these things will be good. All these things will be good. But when we are spiritually minded, this pahaka, this pepper, this chili will be good for health. When you are carnally minded, the same chili will bring tumor in life. It's not the question of a chili or no chili or less chili. But you are spiritually minded or carnally minded. If you are spiritually minded, the chili will be tasty. If you are carnally minded, the chili will be disastrous. So we have to deliver ourselves from all filthiness in the spirit, all filthiness in our flesh, in our carnal nature, in our carnal nature, all filthiness. Face, that beard speaks about your carnal nature. Face is the index of the mind. So upon your spirit, upon your psyche, upon your mind, thought, soul, sukhi, heart, emotions, likes, dislikes, let this anointing touch you. Let this holy oil touch you. It should run down on your beard. It should touch your nature, your spirit, your nature. And it is poured forth so profusely, it runs on your garment. Garment, in the Bible, it speaks about the life of testimony. A person is seen by his garment. When you see a person, you can't see his heart, you can't see his spirit, but only see his garments. Then you can understand his flesh, then you can understand his spirit. You can see a person only by his garments, the garments of the bride, the garment of Jesus Christ, the garment of Joseph. That's a very big study, the study on a garment, the queen's garment, the king's garment. The robe of righteousness, the robe that was blood washed, it's a very big study. But simply it speaks about our life of testimony, our behavior. It touches our spirit, it touches our soul, and it touches our behavior. This anointing should touch our behavior, our spirit, our soul, and our body. I just read to you a couple of verses and conclude. A verse that you are familiar with, Romans chapter 12, verses 1 and 2. Beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. And be not conformed to this world. Don't behave like people in the world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, because the anointing touches your mind, because this holy oil, because this ointment touches your mind, because this ointment touches your mind. By the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Perfect will of God. Transformed. Let your appearance change. Let your haircut change. Let the way that you shave, shave your beard change. Your sideburns. Because of the renewing of your mind, your jewelry, your fabs. Let there be a change because of the renewing of your mind. You are changed. Your dress changed. Your hairstyle changed. Because of the renewing of your mind. Always you have got three questions. What is the perfect will of God? What is acceptable to God? What is good for God? Because of the renewing of your mind, your body changes. Your transformed. And 1 Timothy 4:12, please make a note of this. 1 Timothy 4:12, let no man despise the youth. When I got saved, I was 21. This is the verse the Lord gave me. Let no man despise the youth, but be thou an example. It's not example of the believers, means don't be an example to the believers. Viswasigalukku maadhiriya irukkanum illa. The literal meaning is, be an example of a believer means be a viswasingirukku maadhiriya. You may be 20, you may be 21, you may be 25, you may be just finishing your school, or you just joined the college. Nee oru viswasi, nee oru kristhava, nee oru kristhava appadingirukku maadhiriya. Matra viswasigalukku maadhiriya endralla, you be an example that you are a believer, example of a believer. No one will despise you of your youth. So when this anointing oil touches you, it should touch your behavior. When you are in the school, you are a teacher, you are a student, you are in the college, or you are in a corporate office, or you are a pastor. But let your behavior show that you are a believer. You are a child of God. So they are not going to see my spirit. They are not going to see my mind. They see my behavior. So it says, be an example of a believer in word, in conversation. That word conversation means behavior. Behavior is the index of mind. Behavior is the index of mind. Psychology is the study of behavior. Why you behave like this? Why you dress like this? Why don't you dress like others? Why you want to have a hairstyle like this? Why your tailoring is like this? Why don't you want to have a deep cut like this? Why do you want to put dupatta like this? Everything, there is a reason. Why you don't want to put dupatta like this? Why do you put dupatta like this? Just wearing a dupatta, that speaks about your mind. That speaks about your nature, 100%, 200%. That's you. That's you. Is that nobody has to teach you? Your mother doesn't need to show, hey, put on dupatta like this. The pastor doesn't need to tell you, hey, dupatta report. Is your mind will tell you. You are the renewing of the mind. Your mind says why you should put dupatta. And how you put dupatta. You don't want to put dupatta like somebody else put the dupatta. You want to put dupatta as your mind says. That is you. Whether you agree with me or not. This is a fact. That is you. That is the person inside you. Your conversation, your behavior. Those who studied even the primary lesson on psychology, you know, psychology is the science of behavior, the study of behavior. Psychology, your behavior is the index of your mind. Your behavior is the index of your mind. Let me tell you again, your behavior is the index of your mind. You just do it because your mind tells you to do it. I'm not harsh on anybody, but I want you to know who you are. Because that is a great success. Socrates said, you must know who you are. You must know who you are. Every behavior of you shows who you are. So in your behavior, the word conversation means behavior. In your behavior, be an example that you are a believer. And we read in James chapter 5 verse 13. James chapter 5 verse 13. Is any among you afflicted? Let him pray. Is any merry? Let him sing praises. In the letter it says, if any wise, show that in your behavior. Show that in your conversation. And in 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 15, but as he which hath called you is holy, so be holy in all manner of conversation, in all manner of behavior. Show that you are set apart for the Lord. Your life is for the Lord. As I said, hairstyle, dress, whatever you want to do. You want to show that I am for the Lord. I am in the Lord's business. And 1 Peter 3 verses 1 and 2. Likewise, you wives, be in subjection to your own husbands, that if any obey not the word, that also they without the word be won by the conversation of the wives, while they behold your chaste conversation coupled with fear. Not only for wives. You want to lead others to salvation. You want to lead others to salvation. Be careful about your behavior. Your behavior will lead others to salvation. Your behavior will lead others to salvation. 1 Peter chapter 3 verse 16. Having a good conscience, that whereas they speak evil of you, as of evil doers, they may be ashamed that falsely accuse your good conversation in Christ. Those who are accusing you, those who are falsely accusing you, let them see your behavior. So this anointing should touch the robe of Aaron. So how can dwelling together in unity is possible? That ingredients are very essential, and that should be in the prescribed measure, and that should be compounded as the Lord directs, And that should be poured upon the head of Aaron. And head, beard, and the robe. The spirit, the soul, the mind, and our behavior should be touched by that anointing. 2 Peter 3:11. Seeing then that all these things shall be dissolved, what manner of persons ought you to be in holy conversation and godliness? What manner of person ye ought to be? What manner of person you should be? What manner of person you should be? What type of person you should be? That person, the soul, the spirit, the inner man, the spirit man. What manner of person that ought to be? That's seen in your conversation. That's seen in your behavior. Let this oil, this anointing, with cinnamon, with cassia, with calamus, with myrrh, compounded with oil only, touch your spirit, touch your mind, let it run over your behavior, let that control your behavior. My dear brother, my dear sister, living together in unity is not difficult. Shall we pray? Commit your life into the hands of the Lord. Your life must be made of these principal spices mixed with oil only, taken to the God's prescription, compounded with a spiritual art, but not to be kept in a flask, in a bottle, in a horn. Three things, it should be poured out. It should be filled again and again, and again poured out. It should be filled in again and again poured out. It should be poured out. Poured out on Aaron's head, called, chosen, separated from others, and joined with the Word of God. And that anointing should touch your total personality, the spirit, soul, and body. And living together in unity is very easy. There the Lord commands His blessings, the very life. Just pray for a minute. Lord, I pray that this anointing may touch my spirit, soul, and body. Those who want to sincerely pray, just slip your right hand up. Pray one word. Lord, just slip your right hand up. And pray this one. Lord, let this anointing touch my spirit, soul, and body. Hallelujah. Praise you, Lord. We thank you, Jesus. Bless your people, O Lord. Send your people back home with your heavenly benedictions.